Hey YouTube, my name is Jason. I'm recording this video to essentially give a step-by-step process that I use to achieve these SEO results that you're seeing on the screen. I want to give a shout out to the Neuron Writer Family Facebook group where I originally posted this screenshot of SEO results that I had achieved for one of my law firm clients, and I got such an overwhelming amount of interest and encouragement for me to make this video, so I'm doing that now. So I just want to again just want to thank the Neuron Writer Family Facebook group and everyone who expressed interest and liked my post. I really didn't expect this type of reception or reaction, and so I'm going to be laying down the exact steps that I took to achieve these results. I'm not hiding anything. This will be the type of video that I wish I had when I first started doing and learning SEO. Hopefully, this will be helpful to someone in the Neuron Writer Family Facebook group as well as on YouTube in general. So, just a bit of an overview about the results that I had achieved. This is for a law firm. And as you can see here in the screenshot, their SEO sort of performance, the total clicks and the total impressions, stayed really stagnant. From end of 2022 all the way to the middle of 2023. I started working with this law firm client around June 2023, and since then you'll be able to see the results increasing, the performance increasing steadily over time. And besides this one break during Christmas, where obviously not many people will be Googling lawyers or stuff that lawyers will offer on Google, so there's obviously a dip. There's a dip here in search volume and clicks, but after the Christmas break, the results picked right back up. So this is a 400% increase in organic traffic to our client's website, and that has also led to a 400% increase in leads that they're getting from the website as well. So, what are the steps that I use and take to achieve these results? Well, firstly is keyword research. So, the approach that I take with researching the keywords is quite unique, I think, and is not what many people would expect. I don't use keyword research tools. So, Semrush, Keyword Revealer. I don't know any other tools out there because I don't use them. Ahrefs, I think, Ahrefs or something. I don't use those tools to find keywords. I actually find the keywords by educating myself on the actual topic that I'll be writing the topic that I'll be writing the article about. And so, in this case, I learned almost everything about this area of law that this law firm specializes in and for which they want to gain more leads. And so, I would learn about the area of law, I'd read existing articles online from competitor law firms, and really understand the type of clients that this law firm wants for this area of law. If you're an agency, I highly recommend doing something similar for whichever niche that you're specializing in. If you work in a plumber niche, then you should really understand what are the common issues that customers of plumbers are really care about, really are Googling for. And if you're running your own business and you're a solopreneur, then who else is better than yourself to really understand what your customers and ideal clients are looking for. So once we get an understanding of the actual the problems, the situations, the issues experienced by the ideal clients of this particular niche, then I would simply do a Google of these common problems that they would have. And they would the, these major these keywords would just be the keywords that I target for, because from my experience, from my knowledge and understanding of the industry and the topic, this would be the keyword that they'll be Googling when they want to find an answer to this question or how to solve this issue. So a good example is how to recover rental income from strata defects. by educating myself on strata law or property law or construction law, I understood, and obviously I would talk to a law firm client about this as well, who would validate my observations. I would start understanding what are the common issues that they would have, that the clients of the law firm will have. And one of these common issues would be if there are defects in apartments or you know, apartment blocks and units, and that has caused your own investment property in that apartment block to lose rental income. For example, if there's cracks in the walls or there's mold in the apartments, and it's difficult to find a tenant for that property, then a lot of property owners in that apartment building would want to see how they can recover, how they could get that rental income paid back to them from somewhere, right? From the owners of the from the owners of the apartment block, or from the developers of the apartment block. So that's the common question that I figured that these clients of our law firm client would be Googling for. And so this would just be the search term that I'll be trying to rank highly for. I'll write an article that essentially answers that specific question. And that is the main research keyword. Sorry, that is the main keyword researching method that I use. It is really the only keyword research method that I use. I don't use SEMrush or HRFs or Ahrefs or other keyword research tools like Lowfruits and all that, because most, if not all the time, from my experience, those keywords are too broad and they don't actually answer or relate to a specific problem or an issue that the potential site visitor is Googling or trying to find a problem or trying to find an answer for. So instead of relying on these keyword research tools, I would just understand deeply about the topic or the area of topics that I'm writing about, and then use my brain, really, and my intuition, use my experience as a human, putting myself in their shoes, to really, you know, come up with a few keywords or search result, or come up with a few keywords or search terms in Google that they would be searching for to answer those issues or questions or situations. So that is the keyword research stage. The next step is analyzing the competitors, analyzing who already has articles about this topic or who has articles already answering this question. So what I would do, let's just say I use this particular search term as an example. I want to write an article that ranks highly for this particular search term. What I would do is I would look at the top ranking articles in Google for these search terms, and I would read them. I would get educated on the topic. I would understand what are some common themes, what are some common like answers and subtopics or paragraphs that are addressed in each of these articles. And that would inform me of the actual content that should be in my article. So for example, in this one here, they talk about, you know, claims against the owners corporations insurers. I'll see if there's any other articles that talk about claims against insurers. I'll also have a look if there's any sort of common, because this is a legal article, I'll see if there's any common cases or legislation or laws and regulation that's mentioned and across all these different articles on the same topic. And then I would again include those topics in this article as well. That's what I would do. I would literally look at, I'll read the top ranking articles and see what I should include in my article. But not only that, I'll also see what I could include that they aren't including. And so because I'm reading this, these different articles, I'll be able to see what some articles have omitted, but which another article has included. I would include that new that one topic that was omitted in most of the articles. I'll add that into my article as well. And so I would build up an outline of subtopics in this one article that would cover all these different topics that this range of competitors would cover. I'll put it all in one article, and then that will be the outline. So that is really the next step. I would really literally just look at the competitors' articles. I would get all the common article topics, put them in the article, and then also get some article topics that didn't appear in a few articles but appeared in another article, and then I'll add that to the article outline as well. So that is really the next step, is competitive research and making sure that your article or my article was the most comprehensive, has all the topics, and goes and talks about all the relevant subtopics that answers the question of the article. At this point in time, I want to talk about NeuroWriter, because NeuroWriter was really helpful in optimizing the article that I write. So in this case, and if you don't know what NeuroWriter is essentially an online platform that helps you write articles or optimize articles to rank highly on Google for certain keywords. So in this case here, you can see I've tried to write articles that rank for all these different keywords, right? Construction lawyer, GST strata, design and building, practitioners and act, all that. These keywords, again, I mentioned earlier in the video, these keywords I just made up from my understanding of what these people, ideal clients and customers would be Googling. So again, they're not from a program or a list or anything. I really just use my intuition to put myself in the site visitor's shoes to really try to see what they would be Googling to answer the common questions and situations that they will find themselves in. So NeuroWriter is really good because I'm able to then include a new query, and I'll put in something like, there are cracks in what to do if there are cracks in my apartment lawyer, something like that, right? So in this case, I'm imagining that especially from my understanding of this area of law, there will be a lot of apartment owners who may experience cracks in their apartment, and they want to see what they can do under the law to really be compensated, or what they should do in general. And so I'll put in the search term, which I think they'll be Googling and which I want to rank highly for. I'll put in the country and then the language, and then press start, and then what NeuroWriter will do. And this is, you'll be familiar with this if you guys know what NeuroWriter is. NeuroWriter will then look at the top ranking search results on Google. NeuroWriter will look at the top ranking search results on Google for this particular question that someone has answered into Google, and then they would analyze what are the most common keywords in each of those articles, which we should include in our article to help our article rank higher than them. So that is... and so this is NeuroWriter's role in the process of achieving these SEO results. Fantastic. It's just finished the query, and so I click into it. And here, again, we'll be, as I mentioned previously, it shows all the top ranking search results on Google that appears when someone Googles this particular question. And then I don't select the top 10. I actually unselect any of the lowest results, because I really don't want to be comparing. I really don't want to be getting keywords from those articles. So I'll be, removing any that's in bold red or bright red rather. I'll also include a few that's further down that has higher content scores. This content score is created by NeuroWriter, depending on their own formulas and stuff. I don't know how it works, but the higher the content score, the better the article is in ranking this for the search term. That's the way I understand it. And then we'll press next, and then what NeuroWriter will do is it would come up with a list of keywords that should be included in the article that I write to help my article rank higher. I've written around 70 articles for this particular law firm client over the course of 9 months. And for every one of those articles, I would put it to NeuroNWriter, and I would include the keywords suggested by NeuroNWriter into the article in order to rank high. You see here that 47 is the score of the highest ranking or the highest scored search result, and I would always want to increase our score to be at least matching the current score, but most times we actually surpass that score. If it's 47, we surpass it by 2 or 3 points, doesn't really matter. We never try to hit 99 or 100. That's just too overkill. And by that point in time, the only way to get it to such a high score like 99 or 100 is to really stuff your article with all the recommended keywords. And the effect is actually counterproductive because it makes the article sound really unnatural and spammy. Overall, it leads to a worse reading experience for the site visitor. The mind frame that we always have when we write articles is we want it to be as educational, easy to read, and helpful as possible for the site reader, because it means if it's really helpful, if it's really educational, if it's really valuable, the site reader will read the article for a lot longer, they'll stay on the website for a lot longer, and it also indicates to Google that this article is really valuable, and so that helps Google push our article to rank higher. And so we never keyword stuff our articles. We always at least try to hit the top score, and then maybe surpass it just a little bit with a few points, and then we publish it. And so how to actually write the article. So we never used AI writers. I know on AppSumo and stuff, there's heaps of AI writers, and like ChatGPT and everything can also write long form content, I think. I don't know. But we never use AI writers. We always write the articles ourselves. And by that, I don't mean actually sitting down and start typing and writing the article. This is a trick that you can use for any other article that you're writing about, for your agency or for your own business. And it is essentially Googling this keyword that we're trying to rank for, and then finding existing articles on this particular topic and this is sneaky, but I'm telling you this because I want to help you guys. We find a good article, or we find a few different good articles on this particular topic, and we copy the paragraphs that we think is relevant or is written nicely, and we paste that into ChatGPT and ask for ChatGPT to rewrite the article, to rephrase it, so it doesn't sound like the original article, doesn't sound like the original wording, but conveys the same messaging. So what I would essentially do is let's just say this is the introduction. I'll copy the introduction because I like the introduction. And then I would go into ChatGPT. Let's bring my screen here. And I'll be like, I've written a draft introduction to the topic. And I'll put in the topic. So ChatGPT knows what this introduction is in relation to. And I want you to rephrase it so it is more so it's easier to read without compromising on the original messaging and without making the rewritten introduction sound too unnatural. Do not insert any new facts into the introduction, something like that, and then I'll paste in the introduction that I really liked from another article, and then ChatGPT will rewrite it. So you can see here the first cut is not very great because it's almost a word for word type of rewriting. And so what I would do is, in situations like this, is I would say, That is way too similar. Please read the original introduction. Distill the main takeaways and messaging, and then write a whole new paragraph that includes that messaging. I do not want you to follow the same structure as the original introduction. This is where we start playing around with the prompts. And so when it comes to rewriting existing paragraphs that we found online, we would use ChatGPT to rewrite everything. And we would keep doing this iteration until it's different enough, the rewritten draft. And at this point in time, we would then copy that and put it into NeuroWriter as introduction. And we might find another section, right? So if the next subtopic is about an introduction to the relevant legislation, and I like the way that this one was written, I copy that one, I paste it in ChatGPT. Can you please rewrite this as well? This is different enough, so I'll copy that, put into ChatGPT. Sorry, put into NeuroWriter. And because this is a new subtopic, I would include a heading, introduction to the law, something like that. I try to keep it very simple and easy to understand. It's an H2 header. And I'll keep doing this. I'll find another paragraph that I really like. Let's just say this one, right? And it has to make sense, obviously. I'm just doing it a bit quick because this is essentially the steps that I take. But obviously, you need to read the articles that are currently existing, see what makes sense to include in your own article, and then ask ChatGPT to rewrite the existing paragraphs for that particular section of your own article. So I'll do it quickly. Copy that in. I'll put in another H2 header. And then I'll keep going until the entire article has been included into NeuroWriter. And obviously there may be some subtopics in my article which there is no existing paragraph, or there isn't an existing piece of content out there that I could ask ChatGPT to rewrite. At that point in time, I would write it myself. And even then, I wouldn't write like a normal human being. I would actually write something like, I'll put in notes. I'd be like, please write a coherent paragraph on how this also affects developers of apartments. And then I'll then put in notes that I found online about how, you know, about what this paragraph should include, how the warranties affect them. I pressed enter too quickly, but that's essentially what it is. Obviously, if you're asking it to write new content, I have to check the factual validity of what it has written. Most times it does include a few errors or stuff that I wasn't sure about, so I need to Google it to make sure it's correct. If it's correct, then I'll copy that, put into NeuroWriter. then, again, have another subtopic, what this law means for developers of apartments, right? And so that's essentially what I would do to write the article. Next, the next step is to actually include these new keywords into the article itself. And so what I would do with that is I would go back to ChatGPT, but I'll copy the whole article. This is the whole article. Put that in. Can you please include the below keywords into the above text without making any phrasing sound unnatural nor forced? Do not change the original meaning of anything in the original article. And do not change the tonality of the article. Something like that. And then I'll paste in the keywords. There's the keywords. Put it in here. That's a lot, right? But what will happen is ChatGPT will never include all of these keywords in the article, no matter how long your original article is, or how short the list of keywords is. What ChatGPT will do is it will include maybe 10 to 20% of the list of keywords that you've included, that you have provided it into the prompt, and that serves as a starting point. So I copy that, put it back into NeuroNWriter. So pay attention, there's a score is 17 right now. If I paste in a new article, now it's 32 because it has included some more keywords. And so at that point in time, I would add in the H2 headers because ChatGPT didn't make these H2 headers. I would then, this is the manual part, I would actually start trying to replace existing words in the article with keywords that haven't been included yet. So this is the manual part of the optimization. But it's the part that really matters because ChatGPT is not ever going to put in every keyword in there. If we try to ask it to input more, it would maybe add in maybe two or three more keywords, but it would also remove some existing keywords that I had included previously. So you take one step forward, you take one step back. And so at this point in time, we just have to manually include the keywords in there ourselves. A few tips and tricks really is adding in a title, and what I do with the title is, I actually never use this, but what I would do with the title is I would say to ChatGPT, please write me a title that is clear, concise, and short, and includes these following keywords. If I don't like it, I'll ask for, please give me 5 more variations following my instructions. I'll ask it to give 5 more variations. I choose a variation that I like or has the most amount of keywords that NeuroNWriter has included. I'll put it in here. Let's just see if that... Ooh, that should... There we go. All lights up. I'll do something similar for the description as well. Please write me a short description for this article that includes these keywords. Paste in the keywords. That's really long, so I'll ask it to please cut that in half, but still have the same keywords. Okay, that's probably better. I'll put that in there. Put the description in. Here, again, you've got to play around with the length of the meta description because obviously the current length is far too long. And so here we really just have to I try to fit it underneath the 960 pixels. So I would say something like guide responsibilities of landlords and tenants something like that. Short and simple, and to the point, still includes the keywords, and then I press save and close. And now I can see here that the score has increased to 45. And so we just need two more points. And at that point in time, I'll put in apartment buildings, and I'll find an existing many apartment dwellers. So I'll just put in many tenants of apartment buildings. Hopefully that'll add a point. See if that turns green. That turned green. I don't think it added a point though. I need to put in probably one of these basic terms. So floor, including wear and tear, leaks, cracks in the walls, as well as issues relating to floors. Let's see if I could. That turns green. Fantastic. Score has overtaken the existing high score. At this point in time, I'm happy. I paste this into WordPress, and then I go to Pexels, and I find a related image. I download it, and I make that as a featured image of the article. I don't actually change the name of the file. I just upload it with the original name of the file. And it hasn't made much difference at all. Well, it certainly hasn't made much difference to the results that we've achieved. So I don't have any alt text or anything like that. And then I publish it and add that published article's URL to the Google Search Console to index. I used to do that manually, so I used to go and paste each article URL into Google Search Console to index it, but now I just use a plugin called Instant Indexing by RankMath, and there's a good tutorial. This is a good tutorial here. Where is it? Which one is it? I think it was one of these tutorials. I think it's this one. Yeah, this one here, this is a good tutorial. Essentially, it allows you to... Let me just skip to it. Yeah. Oh, no, not yet. So this tutorial helps you set it up. But at the very end, when we publish like 5 or 8 articles in a bunch or as a batch, I'll just paste in the URL of each of the published articles and then press Get Status and press Send to API, and that would... submit all those articles all at once for indexing, as opposed to manually adding your URL into Google Search Console and indexing that URL and then adding the next one and adding the next one. So that's essentially it. We haven't done anything else besides what I have said in the steps below, said in the steps that I've outlined in this video. We just consistently did it, 5 articles to 8 articles a month. To really summarize the principles and the broad steps that we use to get the results that I had shown in the Facebook group here, it's understanding the topic that we want to write about, understanding the niche that this topic is in relation to, understanding the motivations of the people who are understanding the motivations of the people who are looking to read this article. For example, in law firms, you'll be understanding what their clients or customers care about, what are the questions that they want answered by a lawyer, and then figuring out what is the most common sort of search term that they would Google to help themselves find answers to that question. And that's how you come up with the keyword or the search term. You put that search term into NeuronWriter, like here, for example, put that search term into NeuronWriter. Then you analyze a few of the top existing keywords. You look at the top results for this keyword in Google, read about it, read each of the articles, see what kind of topics they include. Include all those topics across all these articles into your one article that you want to write about. So it's like a mega article that covers everything. So it's the best article, right? and then making sure that the article is written well, is factually correct. I use ChatGPT to rewrite existing content online, so to make it our own, and then we use ChatGPT to start putting in some keywords suggested by NeuronWriter into the article. Once that's done, we'll manually input the rest of the keywords into the article. We'll add in the title, we'll add in the description, and then and we keep doing that until we hit the high score. If we can't hit the high score, then what we do is we'll add in even more topics. But these topics have to be relevant. For example, so instead of adding in some random topic or some topic that doesn't directly answer the question of the article, we would look at an existing topic in the article that we've already written about, and then we would see if we could break it down even more. So for example here, what this law means for owners of apartments. We will then probably break this down into two subtopics, saying the effects on owners of apartments after these new laws are introduced. And we could make that an H2 as well. And we make this what owners of apartments experienced. Sorry, I just put something like what the laws originally were for apartment owners, something like that. But I would look into an existing subtopic that we've written about and see whether we can dive a bit further into that article, into that topic, to make it a bit longer, so we can add in more keywords, and really to really flesh out and go deeper into answering the main question of the article that we're writing about. Once that's done, and once we've hit a high score, then we essentially copy that into WordPress as a new post, add in a featured image, add in the meta title and the meta description, and then publish it, and then send it for indexing. Those are all the steps. That's it. There were a few questions in the Facebook post that some people had left. I think one is, what does Strel do? Strel is very similar to NeuronWriter, because Strel also has a feature that allows you to paste in, or allows you to optimize your article for keywords that exist in other high ranking search results for that particular keyword. So as an example, and I'll use the same search term here for Strel, use the same country. While that's waiting, I'll just copy the fake article that I have written, and I'll put it into Strel to show the differences. Okay, cool. So that's done. I'll click in to the article editor, paste in my content. Oh, fantastic. So it's good. So similarly, it provides you a score, a numerical score, for how well this article has been optimized for the particular keyword that we want this article to rank highly for. The big difference is Strel doesn't give you a target score. It just tells you whether it's good or not out of 100. My team has found that NeuronWriter is a little bit easier for them to know what goal to optimize the article for, because in Strel they don't give you a goal score, so you can keep going until it's 100, but at that point in time your article will be stuffed with keywords, it'll sound way too spammy, everything will sound too unnatural, just so you could force these keywords into the article. So My team likes to use NeuronWriter more because it gives you the actual score that you should aim for. So it makes their job a bit easier. And from what I've seen, the results have been very similar. So that's Strel. Strel also has a low competition keyword research tool, which is similar to a platform called Lowfruits, I think. But I don't use this. I don't use this for keyword research at all. I really just use the content editor. So that's Strel. I'm not sure if there's... Oh, yeah, there's another question here. Do I go and optimize any existing posts? Not really. I don't. So I actually already responded to this question. I've only gone back and optimized old posts where those posts are actually ranking high. And so I optimize it in NeuronWriter, add in a few different keywords, add in maybe an infographic or something like that, and then publish it again. And the only reason I do that is so the article can remain ranking high in Google for the keyword that it's currently ranking high for. Otherwise, I don't bother going back to old articles, because most of the time, those old articles are outdated. They weren't written that well. And really to put in the effort to rewrite those articles so they rank high, are educational, are valuable and easy to read. The effort to do that is almost the same effort, probably if not more effort than actually writing a new article. And so we'd rather just write new articles that are updated, fresh, and really helpful. So that's another question that someone had asked. The velocity, I already answered this question. So Rajashi asked, what's the posting velocity per day? We don't post anything per day. We used to post 5 articles per month, and now we do 8 articles per month. I know a lot of NeuronWriter users use NeuronWriter to pump out a lot of articles like per day. That's a different business model to how we want our clients to publish articles, because from our experience, only really good, well-written, well-researched, and helpful articles rank high in Google and demonstrate the authoritative expertise that our clients have and how they could help the site reader. We can't do that we're not able to create such articles at such velocity where we can start posting these per day. It's usually 5 to 8 per month. Again, if your business model is to create as many articles as you can to rank them high and to get affiliate links and all that, that's certainly your prerogative. But that's not the business model that we operate for our clients in terms of SEO. Let's see if there's any other. Are you optimizing both landing pages and blog content using NeuronWriter? Fantastic. Yes, I said that I'll answer this question. Yes, we do. We optimize both the blog content through the process that I have shown, but we also optimize the landing pages for the law firm as well. So if the landing page for the law firm is construction law, then we would literally copy the existing content of the current construction law landing page, paste it into NeuronWriter, with a search term that we want to target being construction lawyers, and then we would rewrite all the site copy and include the new keywords that NeuronWriter has suggested. And we did that for all the landing pages of this current client, and we got one of those landing pages ranked number one for the main search terms, and they were ranked 28 or 24. And through that process, we managed to rank them number one. So to answer your question, Asif, yes, we optimize both the landing pages and the blog content using NeuronWriter. If you've made it this far into this 40-minute video, one tip that I want to, I don't know if a lot of people knew this, I certainly didn't until very recently. A big portion of why we were able to get our client's landing page to rank number one was because we had created so many blog articles that were helpful, educational, and valuable that Google saw our client's website as an authoritative figure or a topical expert on this particular search term. And then that's why it started ranking our client's page as number one. And so there's a tip for you. If you want to rank number one for highly competitive search terms, you should write a whole bunch of articles over half a year. And but those articles have to be high quality and really helpful and really easy to read. So it helps the site reader with their problem. So I guess I went on a tangent answering Asif's question. I don't know if there's any others. Again, someone asked here, how many articles did you publish since you started using NeuroWriter? Almost 70 now. That's about it. So hopefully this video was helpful. This is the first time I sort of make these type of videos. I don't normally make videos at all. It's good practice though. But if you have any other questions, just leave a comment down below or just message me directly on Facebook or something. And I read all the comments, as you can see here on this Facebook page. On this Facebook post, I read all the comments. Hopefully this was helpful, and thanks so much for watching.